on the Medical Watch, improving hearing.
As medical reporter Dana Baird tells us tonight, it all hinges on the little hairs in the ear.
Earbuds, noise pollution, and age all diminish hearing. More specifically, damage hair cells in the ear. We're born with them, and they typically thrive for the duration of our lives. But as some die, they do not regenerate. A new finding could change that. His office is filled with art.
It's the matador there and the bull. Final moment.
Surrounded by inspiration from his home country of Spain, in Chicago, Illinois, this doctor has made the art of dance his focus.
It is a dance. It is a beautiful dance.
The music that triggers the dance could be song or speech. The noise stimulates hair cells to move, helping us hear.
These cells crouch and jump, and so they make the vibration bigger. And so they lift these cells. These are the cells, the ones in pink, who are swung further, and then send the information to the brain.
The outer and inner hair cells are perfectly aligned.
These are the inner hair cells and the outer hair cells.
The outer cells amplify sound, while the inner cells send signals to the brain. If just a few are out of place.
This one's missing and that one's missing.
Hearing is compromised. So researchers at Northwestern University set out to regenerate hearing cells.
You need both of them to work in conjunction. Or you hear very poorly.
They discovered a gene to turn up the volume.
One gene called TBX2 that if we take it from the inner, they form an outer, and we put it in the outer, they form an inner. It's what we call the master regulator, because the presence or absence of this gene will determine whether you make the hair cell will form one type or the other. When you generate now an artificial hair cell in the ear of an adult, we hope we can use this gene regulator to make it tell it to make an inner hair cell or an outer hair cell. A cell that sends information to the brain or a cell that moves in response to sound and increases amplifies the sound.
Now they'll insert the gene into the ear with the hope of growing new hair cells and restoring hearing.
The good news is that we have now tools to address these questions.
Doctors say hearing loss is the most common degenerative condition in humans. We all lose some hearing as we age. Now that they found the gene to help, they will test their theory in mice and then people. Back to you.